you have to go to people's doors, and two out of every three, or maybe more, are going to be Republicans. And you have to focus on that because, you know, you need those folks to vote for you. A lot of people think that Democrats in Wyoming must be from somewhere else. Well, you know, most of us are born and raised in Wyoming. I'm Pete Gosar. I'm the former chair of the state Wyoming Democratic Party and the Democratic gubernatorial candidate in 2014. You immediately face, you know, the 2-to-1 odds against you, or maybe a little bit bigger than that. It's tough to get money and to raise that type of funds available to be competitive.
I was told that there were about 5,000 people who participated in the last Wyoming caucus. It looks like all of them are here tonight. Thank you.
I'd say the biggest challenge is making people believe that we have a chance and that their voices will be heard by their representation. I'm Amy Van Cleve, and I'm the executive director of the Wyoming Democratic Party. I think the thing that's most unique about politics in Wyoming is that at the end of the day, people don't play politics. What's unfortunate that isn't unique to Wyoming is that within the majority party, we've seen in the past couple of years a trend for moderates who tend to work with us to be targeted by their own party and replaced by more conservative versions of themselves.
The boogeyman in your head is always a lot bigger than the boogeyman that exists. And so, you know, I think for me, the goal is to get people to say, well, you know what, sure, it might be long odds, but if you never start, then you never win.